Friends, welcome to this tutorial series on Network Analysis Made Simple. In this tutorial, we shall discuss on Introduction to Transients in Electrical Networks. Friends, study of transients is as important as steady state analysis. In this tutorial, we shall study about what are transients, how they affect the performance of electrical networks, and so on. Transient is an interesting phenomenon, friends. I hope you enjoy this presentation on Introduction to Transient Analysis. Let's go ahead. Friends, do you know what is a transient? In my opinion, transient is a phenomenon which occurs knowingly or unknowingly in all physical system operations, including human beings. Are you surprised? Yes, friends, transients do occur even in human being. For example, consider an ECG waveform recorded for a human being as shown in figure. The first part is the ECG when a person's activities are normal. The second part of the waveform is his ECG when he is experiencing a severe heart attack or heart arrest. The third waveform shows the final state. Hope you know what it is. Similarly, transients occur in machines and in electrical networks too. Consider the waveform of current drawn by a DC motor when it is started at t is equal to 0 by applying the supply. During the first state, the motor is at rest, current drawn is 0. After the power supply is switched at t is equal to 0, you see that the current drawn increases suddenly and it takes some time to decrease during the transient state. After some time, the motor draws normal, no load or load current as the case may be. Observe that the normal current drawn remains constant. Next, consider the transient in induction motor starting. Here also, you see that the starting current increases enormously and take some time to reach normal state as seen. Observe that during transient state, current changes are non-periodical. But during steady state, the current varies periodically. So friends, we can define a transient as a transit state from one steady state to another steady state. Observe that this happens in all the examples that we have described. So it also may be stated that the transient state is a temporary state. It vanishes with time, produces non-periodic variations, and magnitudes of non-periodic variations will be many times more than the normal values. Because of these reasons, friends, transient variations may cause disastrous effect when they occur. Friends, now let us see when and why transients appear in electrical networks. In the first place, transients may appear due to switching. Switching could be manual or due to the operation of protecting devices or due to the shape of the supply waveforms such as clock signals, for example. Transients may also appear due to unforeseen reasons such as faults and short circuits. When faults occur or when system is overloaded, you know the protecting devices operate and disconnect the supply. Under such circumstances also, transients may appear and produce large variations of voltages and currents. Then, you may be thinking, which property of circuit elements produce transients? Friends, you know that inductance and capacitance store energy in them. The voltage across inductance, VL is equal to L into di by dt, or L is equal to phi L divided by di by dt. What does this mean? Friends, inductance is a property of a circuit element which opposes the change in current. Observe the equation for L. You see that di by dt appears in the denominator, and that is the reason. Further, you also know that energy stored in inductance EL is equal to half Li square, and this energy is stored in the form of electromagnetic field in the inductance. Similarly, current through the capacitance IC is equal to C into dV by dt, or C is equal to IC divided by dV by dt. What does this mean again? Friends, capacitance is a property of a circuit element which will oppose the change in voltage across it. You see that dV by dt is appearing at the denominator in the equation of capacitance. This energy is stored in the form of electrostatic field in the capacitance element. So friends, it is interesting to note that these energy storing elements, inductance and capacitance, are responsible for the characterization of the entire electrical network. Do you know? Friends, an electrical network as a physical system is characterized by certain energy conditions in its operation, both in steady state and during transients. Friends, now it is a time to distinguish the process of energy transfer in transients. One thing you know, during steady state, the variations of voltages and currents remain constant in DC circuits, whereas in AC circuits, they vary periodically. That is what we say, parameters in the steady state are time invariant. Then, what will happen to energy component? Friends, during steady state, energy stored in inductance and capacitance elements are supplied by DC sources in DC circuits, whereas the energy in AC circuits is changed periodically or transferred between inductance and capacitance elements. But friends, remember, energy transfer or energy distribution during transient cannot happen instantly or abruptly, because you know that the change in magnetic energy requires change in current, but inductance will oppose the change in current. Similarly, change in electrical energy requires change in voltage, and the capacitance element will oppose the change in voltage. That is exactly the reason why the change in voltage and currents take some time to reach the steady state values during transients. Of course, this time could be very small in terms of milli or microseconds, but magnitudes of voltages and currents during transients might be so large to cause damage to the system. Hope it is clear to you all. Friends, from the earlier discussion, we have clearly understood regarding transients, how they appear, what circuit elements produce transients, and so on. Friends, if I ask you, are transients desirable? What is your answer? Friends, my answer is both yes and no. No, because in large power systems, the transient voltages and currents are so large in magnitude so as to damage the equipment itself and bring in instability in the system operation. Further, large amplitudes may cause interference with the adjacent networks. Also, they may increase the thermal distortion and also increase the electromagnetic stresses on the system. But in contrast, friends, you know that all electronic systems work on digital signal, and you know clock is a signal which is switched from 0 to 1 and 1 to 0 at every half cycle. Also, you know most of the electronic systems contain energy storing elements. Therefore, transients are produced in every electronic system, but for their safe working, these transients are controlled and systems are designed to overcome the transient effects in electronic systems. Friends, transients in electrical systems are undesirable, but they appear in electrical systems due to frequent switching, and hence measures are to be taken to protect the systems by providing protecting devices. In electronic systems, they are unavoidable and desirable as all electronic systems work on clock. Friends, I hope this presentation has ignited some of your thoughts. If so, please forward your feedback and suggestions to my email. Thank you for watching this video.